Hello everyone, I am Astha, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am going to show you how poor waste management system India is currently following and how much waste India generates annually and also how we can solve our waste disposal problem in India. But before that, let's see India's waste generation in a global perspective. As you saw yourself, India's waste generation is far less than the West, but yet the West looks clean and shiny, and in the other hand our Indian streets looks dirty and unhygienic. What's the possible reason behind this mess? Mainly two. First is the poor waste management system in India. Second, lack of awareness in the people and the habit of littering on the streets. India needs to learn recycling and waste management techniques from the West, but never the Western consumption habits. Why? Let me show you the composition of waste generated in India, according to a study of Indian Metro Cities 2000. India generates about 41% organic or biodegradable waste, 40% inert waste, 6% paper waste, 4% plastic waste, 4% textile waste, 2% glass waste, 2% metal waste, and 1% leather waste. India generates about 41% of organic waste, which can easily be collected and composted by a decentralized system of composting the organic waste, which can easily be used as natural fertilizers for the plants and trees and also for making natural fuels. It is said, and rightly said, that what comes from the soil must go back to the soil. In this way, India can solve 41% of its waste problem itself. And in absence of segregating and composting the waste, the organic waste gets dumped into the landfill sites where it produces methane and greenhouse gases which pollutes the air, soil, and our groundwater. So, our next 40% waste generated by India is the inert waste. Inert waste is neither chemically or biologically reactive, and also it does not decompose. Some of the examples of this waste are dirt, rocks, construction materials, debris, bricks, etc. Inert waste does not dissolve, burn, physically or chemically react, or adversely affect other matter which may pollute the environment. Inert waste occupies a lot of space in the landfills, and also it takes a lot of energy to make it constructed, and of course it's still a huge part of the waste. So India needs to come up with a brilliant strategy to reduce and treat the inert waste, most probably by prevention, reusing, recycling, recovering, and at last disposing them. If we solve only the last two categories of waste, India can fight its 81% of the waste disposal problems, and rest 19% of the waste management needs really good techniques and measures, because this 6% paper waste, 4% plastic, 4% textile, 2% glass, 2% metals, and 1% leather waste can mostly be recycled by the recycling industries if we segregate our recyclable waste and throw it into recycling bins. And the government should take necessary actions for recycling these waste. Mainly, plastic recycling here must be taken into great consideration. Although some of these waste cannot be recycled, for which both the government and public should make some necessary changes in their lifestyles. The government should make engineered landfill sites to prevent the waste from releasing toxic gases into the air and polluting and releasing chemicals in our groundwater. And public should reduce their overconsumption habits and live a more sustainable lifestyle by boycotting single-use plastic and non-recyclable plastic, reducing their need for products, using less paper, and just limiting their wants into needs by adopting 7 hours of sustainability, which I'll tell you in my upcoming videos. And our waste management problem can easily be solved if we start segregating our solid waste into at least 4 categories initially, which is first, organic and biodegradable waste, second, recyclable waste, third, domestic hazardous waste, and fourth, e-waste. So, this way, we can solve or at least 90% of the waste disposal problem in India. And if we are successful in doing this, India can be no doubt cleaner, healthier, and prosperous than ever. But for that, both public and government should contribute, and we all will keep fighting for a cleaner and greener India. We have already faced a lot of climate disasters this year and previous year. Millions of animals died in the Australian bushfires. Millions of trees got burned in the Australian and Amazon fires. In our country, India, Delhi is facing hazardous level of air quality. Yamuna is dead. We ran out of groundwater in many metropolitan cities. We have already destroyed so much. How much more we need now? It's a climate emergency. Wake up, don't just hope for some miracle to happen, work for it together. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching Plastic Free India. Namaste.